Hi there, this is Evan from 3dprops.com and today I'm going to review my latest buy and that is the Zeelus 50 watt CO2 laser cutter engraver. I bought this machine on Amazon for around 1300 euros and yeah, I was pretty amazed. It was delivered pretty quick. I took the option to ship it from the Czech Republic. And that made it very easy for shipping in the European Union. So no import taxes and that kind of stuff. So yeah, pretty cool. The shipping was a little bit surprising because they didn't update the tracking information. And all of a sudden I was just starting my shop in the morning, like 9 o'clock, and the doorbell went and there was a big wooden crate in the front of my door. Was this machine. A little heads up from the company, and the company is called Ucool from Amazon. It would be nice if they sent me an update on the shipping. So, that said, this machine has a Rudia controller. I was advised on the internet that that was the best controller to have on your machine. So that's why I picked this one. There are other same type of CO2 laser engravers that have a different kind of controller. So that's why I choose for the Rudia. It also functions with the program that I use, that's Lightburn. It makes it very easy to work with. So yeah, that was my choice for that kind of thing. This one also works with AutoCAD and CorelDRAW. So if you have that and you're looking for a 50 watt laser cutter engraver, it goes along with that. Overall, the machine is pretty cheap, not only in its price, but also in the materials they used. The overall design looks nice, really industrial looks and feel, pretty heavy. It was well packed in a wooden crate, no visible damage or whatever, but I was a bit disappointed about the power switches. And maybe you can pick up the camera, and there are 4 power switches here. This is for the main operation of the whole machine. This one is for the laser, and there was one for the cooling, for the water cooling and the air pump. So what happened is when I tested it for the first time, I put it on and it worked fine, and then I put it out and the top 2 switches just broke. It was very cheap plastic, so I was a little bit disappointed and amazed that a thing that this big and for 13 euros just snapped under my finger. So what I did is immediately I bought 4 new switches, these green ones with there are lights in there or whatever it is. And they're quality stuff, so it's very easy to change them. But I'm kind of disappointed that I not invested a couple of euros extra to make this a good machine. So, and there's more to come on that. Okay, another couple of things that I found a little bit disappointing on this machine. The air assist. There was this little pump was in there. It's an aquarium pump for adding oxygen for the fish, and it just didn't work well enough. There was poor air assist. When I was engraving or cutting, a lot of smoke development. You got flame marks on the objects that I was engraving or cutting, and yeah, a lot of residue because there was a lot of smoke and I don't know how you call it, but the black stuff. Yeah, that was nasty. So I replaced that with a bigger air pump right over there. Maybe you can turn around the camera a little bit. That one. And it has its own power supply. This old one was powered by the laser cutter itself. And that one has just his own power supply. I will come back to that one on the name and where to order it. I will put it back in the link in the YouTube video, so you can order it yourself if you want it. The other thing was that the water pump that come with it, I wasn't satisfied with it either, because when I did beer cutting or engraving projects, the water got really hot, and I was thinking, well, if there's a bigger water flow, it will cool faster. So what I did, I bought a bigger water pump, a bigger, by the way, yeah, there, down there. There is the basin with around 35 liters of water, and the pump goes really fast. I will add up the specs later, and also the link down below. Also, laser cutter didn't come with a simple camera assist. I don't think that if I just spend a little bit more, and I was willing to pay extra to get a complete machine and not have to tinker with all that kind of stuff, it made it real easy for me. But now I had to wait and order stuff and install it and trial and error and everything like that. Of course, it was a great way to learn about this machine and to go on the internet to see more about the machine. And yeah, it helped me with a big learning curve for the machine. But kinda, if they just spent a little bit more, that wasn't needed. Also, I made this table from an aluminium profile. It's profiles 40 by 40 millimeters. Added some good wood wheels on it. It's really sturdy, and it gives some extra mobility, because I got not enough space here for just walking around the machine. What would be most ideal, of course. But now I can just put it aside, get on the back, put it back, lock the wheels, and I'm good to go. So yeah, it makes it real nice and easy and mobile. So yeah, I can recommend this, because you can also adjust it to the sizing that you want, because you just order the right size for the frame, and yeah, it's like an hour build to create this table, so pretty easy. And overall, plus side is cheap to buy. Really, 300 euros isn't that much for a machine like this. But what I said, if I just ask 1500 euros for it, it will be complete like it is here. So yeah, if you see this, you for you cool, please do that. Offer your clients a complete system with good switches, camera, good air assist, and good water pump. It would be awesome. And believe me, they are willing to pay. Essential mods on this machine by name, and I will put the link below. The air pump is a 30 watt, 60 liters per minute. Now, that's a lot more compared to the other older air pump. Where is it? This one goes in the garbage. Don't need it anymore. The water pump is 50 liters per minute. That's also a lot more. I bought this milliamp meter. I have to install it. I just got it last week and didn't have the time yet to install it. But it's very important, because you will be able to see how much power your machine really uses. And if you put out too much power, if you go full 100%, the lifetime of your laser will go down rapidly. So maximum power that you can use is like 80%, and you need this amp meter for that. Oh yeah, I really forgot about that. That was crazy. What happened? I think the third time that I used this machine, the fuse is blown. A hole in my house, and the high power supply that is in there, and I can show you that one. I got a new one from Yuko. That was good service from them. They really acted fast. When I contacted them, they asked me to make a video of the problem, and I did. You can see it also on my YouTube. that I addressed what the problem was with the high power voltage power supply. And I didn't know how long it would take, so I ordered another one. Plus they would send me a replacement, and they sent me this replacement. But this previous high power supply, what was in there, had I opened it and I could see that there was a little resistor there that was blown. It was just gone. And I found it very strange that a machine that I just ordered, and within three jobs it would just die. That was crazy. So yeah, that cost me some extra bucks. Cool thing of this, one has also an amp meter, but it is in there. So you have to open it up to look how much it uses on power, and that's not ideal. So that's why this little guy, and I will install it right here or somewhere else, or maybe I will do it just with a wire and a 3D printed bracket for it or something like that, I don't know. I can do that in the next video. So that was a big issue with this machine. So that was also very disappointing. The water tank, 30 liters, that was not great. I had a little one with 20 liters. Water temperature went up pretty fast. So that's down now already, it's better. I added a 5 megapixel 1080 Full HD cam. Not too expensive, really. And easy to install. You can find the bracket files to 3D print on Thingiverse. I also believe there is one that you can laser cut. You just look to it for yourself, so pretty easy. The only problem was there was a small cable from 1 meter, and I really needed 3 meters because my laptop is over there. So I had to solder two cables together, and that's how I fixed the problem. So pretty awesome. I will show you later how this works, this camera. It's pretty nice. Overall, all the updates and upgrades and mods and stuff that I had, it was around 200 euros, excluded from the high voltage replacement. So again, it was an Amazon buy. Z-Zulus 50 watts CO2 laser cutter with a Relia controller, and I will show you some things. I will engrave my logo in a piece of acrylic, and we make a time lapse from that so you can see how it works. And yeah, it's pretty cool because that's one of the nice things of the camera. You can position your image that you want to engrave or cut. You can exactly locate it where you want it. Because of the camera assist, it's pretty easy. Also, you can make live videos, streaming or time lapses, so you can show people how it works. So we will do that. I will power up the machine. Right here. We start on this side. We start with the top power. That will activate the whole machine. Air pump and the water pump. And this one is to activate the laser. I will leave it off because first you have to make sure everything is okay. And then you will activate the laser. Because first, high voltage, very dangerous when you're working with the stuff. And yeah, this is a safety measure. Only put it on when you use it. Okay, the Relia controller right here is a pretty simple, basic layout. Press file, you can just enter by down arrows, check for what kind of stuff you want to do. There's some fun stuff, of course, some tests. This is one of my logos that I use for making these kind of blaster tags. And I put it on the back where I put my logo. So what we're gonna do is first see if the calibration is right, the the focus distance from the lens to object, and it has to be in the right position. So we'll put this piece under the nozzle and just go up until I feel some friction. I feel some friction, and that's the right position. So that's okay. Press escape again, goes back to the home position. And now we will go to my laptop and I will show you how Lightburn will work. And I'll show you the camera, how it works, and how to position your image. Okay, let's start the machine. Right here, that's the honeycomb I was talking about. It's another thing you can order from Amazon. So, same position. Closing the machine. And on the time lapse you can see the all overall the acrylic, and you will see how it works and operates. So, I'll go to the Rudia controller, press escape, just to be sure it's in the home position, press file, and there is a logo. You can also see the image right there. Now what I'm going to do, I go to track. And with that, I will check for sure that my material is aligned properly with the size of the image. So now we are sure it's aligned properly, go to the site. Okay, again, file. Oh. Run and enter. And now it is engraving. Pretty fast speed. I can tell. Really curious about the effect of the speed combined with engraving, if that's enough power and it is accurate enough. So, okay, for now, thanks for watching. We're going to check the time lapse, and yeah, only thing I just want to mention is that I was pretty disappointed about my review on Amazon. Because I was very specific, just like I told you about all the upgrades and the errors that it had and the malfunctions and stuff. And I was giving also positive feedback because shipping was fast, overall machine looks great. With the updates and upgrades and the mods, it is an excellent machine. But Amazon said we won't post your review because it doesn't fit the guidelines of Amazon. So that's why I'm making this review. I hope it's helpful. I want to recommend this machine, or the 40 watt machine, that's a lot cheaper to start and play with. Okay, one more thing. While we're waiting for the time lapse to end for the laser engraving for my logo, I want to show you a little thing that we started last week, and that is our Patreon site. We're going to post a lot of content and tutorials. We'll share files to create the props that we make. In the lower tier you can also buy the files and make it yourself. But on the highest tier, the Tinkerer tier, you can get a free file every month to build your own blaster or other kind of props or whatever. We will regularly post progress on projects. There will be multiple projects on one time. Because we got several employees here that I coach here. There's great guys and girls with autism, and I'm teaching them how to create props. So in order to make it possible for them to go on with new projects that I like, because one guy's completely into World of Warcraft, and we created that awesome Frostmourne blade from the Lich King for him. And that's only one of the projects that we get. Of course, we're going to do a lot of more projects. And in order to make it possible for them to have the files that they need, and the materials, and the attention, and that kind of stuff, we need funds. So please join our Patreon. I will show you where it is. If you go to my website, 3dprops.com. Okay guys, this is my Patreon page. Go to patreon.com/3dprops and you will find a couple of tiers that you can subscribe to. We got 4 tiers in total. We got the supporter tier, that is because you just want to support what we do. It's €2 a month and it will give us the opportunity to just go on with new projects and keep doing what we're doing. Of course, you got voting power. If you see a new project that we are going to start, but we're not sure what kind of project, we will post 3 options and you can just vote for it. That goes for all the tiers. Of course, you can see all the posts that we put up there, the complete archive. We got the enthusiast, and that's for the guys and girls that I really love to create props themselves, or want to learn how to make props. It gives you full access to all our tutorials, and along with the tier from the supporter. Then we got the builder. That's a little bit bigger. It's €15 a month. It's $14.50 there, and it's in dollars, I believe, $15. With that, you get access to our file shop. The projects that we make, and when there are our own designs, we will post the files in that section, and you can buy those files so you can make and print them yourself. Also, there's a nice reward of 50% discount that you can use for buying files or a DIY kit or a finished prop on our website, 3dprops.com. So it gives you some extra nice stuffs added to this tier. The latest tier and the best tier, that's the Tinkerer tier, and that's for the diehard builders among us that really like to get the files for sure and do whatever they want with it. Get full access to all our tutorials and our progress that we do. And of course, you got voting power, complete access to everything. And if you want some commissions or whatever, just do a shout out or email us and we'll see what we can do. And if you've got a great idea, let us know. So please support us so we can do what we do. And well, thank you for watching. Go to patreon.com/3dprops and subscribe for TR, please. If only you can support us for €2 a month, it will make a big difference for us. Hi, thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe and hit the notification bell. I really appreciate your support. So if you like this prop and you want to build it yourself, go to 3dprops.com and order your own kit. So thanks for watching. Bye bye and see you next time.